Yo, I'm Drew Soul Quest. You watching Quest Convo live in Culture 73 Studios. It's the coronavirus edition, and I'm ready. You tuned in to Drew Soul Quest, Quest Convo, the coronavirus edition.
Coronavirus! I'm telling you, shit is real! Shit is getting real!
Man, this coronavirus has changed the world forever. It'll never be the same, man. I want to start off, first of all, just peace to all the people that's really going through it. You know what I'm saying? Regardless of what, like, Waka Flocka is saying.
We here. So coronavirus, are we not worried about it at all?
It's fake.
You think it's an agenda?
Man, I don't think minorities can't catch it. We sure.
They say that one more time.
Minorities can't catch it.
Minorities can't catch coronavirus.
Nah.
Why do you say? Why do you believe that?
Name one.
I don't know, but it could happen.
Name one, though.
It could happen.
Name one of us.
If it hasn't happened, it could happen.
What craziness he talking about? These people on spring break in Florida, chilling on the beach like it's business as usual.
If I get corona, I get corona. At the end of the day, I'm not going to let it stop me from partying. You know, I've been waiting. We've been waiting for Miami spring break for a while.
Hey, man, it's serious business. Like I said, it's people that are sick. You know what I'm saying? This ain't no game. Everything is shut down. Everything is canceled. People are losing money. People don't know how they're going to make it the next few months. Man, it's serious business, bro. Ain't no games with this. You know what I mean? People are really going through it. I want to send out shots and prayers and a whole lot of positivity to the people that's really going through it and, you know, don't know where to turn or whatever. You know what I mean? But y'all use this time, you know, figure out life, man, right through here. This is a wake-up call for everybody. You know what I mean? People need the multiple streams of income. You know, get you a job online. First, matter of fact, start you a business. Become an entrepreneur. You know, get it in, man. You know, a lot of the content creators I know and, you know, people that are doing a lot of things online, you know, they not even feeling the hurt right now. You know what I mean? So y'all just think about it. It ain't all about, you know, everybody is quarantined at the crib right now. It ain't all about just the Xbox and the Netflix and, you know, everything else, man. Really think about life, man. It's, you know what I'm saying? If this don't give you another perspective or some kind of wake-up call, hey, I don't know what to say. But anyway, like I was saying, man, everybody's quarantined. Everybody's locked down. You locked down. I'm locked down. So I was like, why not? Let me speak to the world a little bit about this coronavirus thing. You know, kind of show y'all some of the things I'm on, some of the things that I'm doing for prevention and different things like that. So I'm going to go over that. Then I'm on Apple Music, I did a little, it's under Drew Soul Quest. I did a little playlist for y'all, a little coronavirus lockdown rap playlist. I'm going to go through that. You know what I'm saying? Everybody need a little something to get through this. So I'm going to go through that a little bit for you. But this is some of the things I'm on, man. First of all, like I said, take this thing very serious. I keep reiterating that because I see so many people that are not taking it serious. You know what I mean? And the scariest thing about this is, you know, nobody has like 100% answers. You know what I'm saying? The government, the doctors, the scientists, they don't have a cure for this thing. They don't have, you know, any kind of remedy for it. So I think that's the, like, the scariest part about it. You know, people are looking for answers and nobody has true answers about it. You know what I mean? But the one thing that a lot of the experts are saying, if people don't take this serious and change their habits, it's going to go on much longer, much, much longer. Y'all think y'all hurting, you know, these little few months right here or these couple little weeks or whatever. If y'all don't change your habits, hey, it could go on another year and a half. And that's a whole nother story for you. So you know what I'm saying? Hey, y'all just take it serious. You know, it is what it is. Pretty much they say if you do have it, pretty much everybody's not dying from it. I'm going to say that. But you can have it and not even really have the symptoms like that, but also pass it on to somebody else and get them sick. You know what I'm saying? It's a crazy, weird kind of disease. It really is. It's real crazy like that. But for the most part, everybody's not dying from it. Everybody's not having severe issues from it. For the most part, they say if you got it, quarantine yourself for the 14 days. Pretty much after that, you're good. You know, but in the meanwhile, do what you got to do, like I said, because so far, like I said, nobody has true answers, but they're saying they're saying like vaccinations for this thing could be 12 to 18 months away. And that's, you know, that's not a game, man. That's a year and a half. So we got to do what we got to do. Think about the world. Think about your family. Think about all your loved ones. So first and foremost, I know y'all keep hearing the same little rules, but hey, make sure that happens every 20 minutes, every hour, wherever you're at. Wash your hands. Wash your hands with hot water, with soap, under the water, good, 20 seconds or more. Keep that going. But this is allergy season, cold season. So if you cough and different things like that, cover your mouth, please. Use a tissue, cover your mouth. Throw the tissue away after you're done. I've been out a little bit here and there for some of the essentials, and I've seen people just still coughing, not covering their mouth. It makes me really want to just knock them, punch them in the damn mouth for real, like they have no common sense. Let me get to what I'm doing, and hey, hopefully y'all can pick up on it. Hey, this is what I'm doing to stay healthy through this. So y'all see I got my little products out here. I got the gloves. I got the mask. I'm not playing. When I'm out, I'm looking just like this. Yeah. I ain't even do the medical gloves. I got the black joints on, like I'm about to steal your car, break in your house or something. But hey, I'm just trying to protect myself. So I got the gloves on. I got the mask. Y'all see this? These masks, these little cheap ass masks, these are high top commodity right now. On Amazon, they charging like $50, $60 for them, just taxing. I could sell this little stack right now, probably make me a quick $250 up in here on these little masks, but this is serious. I got some more coming because these are like temporary. Now the ones that really protect you as far as keeping all the airborne stuff out, those are the N95 masks. Some of them are similar to this, but they have like different layers to them and they got a filter in them. You know what I mean? It really keeps those airborne particles out. So I'm waiting on those. I got them coming. See, I got my gloves right here. I just got a pack of them. I think it's like 100 of them. So I'm good on that for a minute. Now, all of this right here, this is what I'm taking to build my immune system. It's so important through this to keep your immune system on 1,000. You know what I mean? So I got my, first of all, I got airborne. This is real popular during the, the winter months for the most part. If you work with a lot of people, different things like that. This has vitamin C, a lot of different things in it. It keep builds up your immune system. So keep these on deck, very important. Right here, y'all may not be familiar with this. These are Goli apple cider vinegar gummies. These are real good. The apple cider vinegar, a lot of people do that, but keep it real. The apple cider vinegar is nasty as hell. it can burn your mouth. It can mess with the enamel on your teeth. You know, so this is a good alternative. You know what I'm saying? You can smell the apple cider vinegar in these, but they don't taste all nasty and crazy. So this is a good alternative, the Goli apple cider vinegar gummies. Right here, I still do the apple cider vinegar because right through here, it's about building up my immune system and staying healthy. Hey, I don't give a damn about the taste right now. it's about building up my immune system and staying healthy. This is the apple cider vinegar. Pretty much you can get that from any store. Make sure if you can get the organic, make sure it got the apple cider vinegar with mother in it. I don't know what mother is, but besides your mama, but the apple cider vinegar with mother in it is supposed to be the one that's really, help you out or whatever. And it's good for your skin, your digestive system, all those different things. I know y'all know what this is. Everybody know what the Lysol is. I'm kind of Lysol crazy right now. I'm spraying that every damn where I go, all in the studio, all everywhere. I'm spraying the Lysol in the car, the door handles, all that. So I got that. Another thing here, these are the disinfectant wipes. Now, pretty much anything I've been touching lately, I've been cleaning my phone with this. I've been wiping down my car handles. If I have had to go out to get anything, whatever I'm touching, door handles, I'm wiping it off with this or opening the door with this. I'm not playing. I'm full force over here. And another thing too, like at least if you ain't gonna do the mask, you feel a certain kind of way about that, at least do the gloves. Because pretty much with this disease, they say you get it from surfaces and airborne, particles or whatever that get on your hands, and we constantly are touching our face. You know what I mean? So just keep that in mind. So the gloves are really important. Even if you don't want to mess with the mask like that, at least get you some gloves, you know. I don't even if you got the winter glove joints, you know what I mean? Just something to cover your hands so different things you're touching, you're not getting germs or spreading germs. And then what else I got over here? Last and not least, good old handy hand sanitizer. I use this as well, even in between me eating or messing with equipment or doing different things. In between, I'm using the hand sanitizer. You know what I'm saying? I'm 1,000 with this. You know, y'all can act like it ain't serious. It ain't no game up in here. So those are just some of the things that I'm doing. I know some of y'all are doing these things. Hopefully I was able to give you, you know, maybe some tips, some different things that you didn't know, open your mind to it or whatever. But you doing these things along with washing your hands and cook at home too. I know a lot of people, you know, no restaurant is really open where you can go eat. They doing a lot of carry out, different things like that. That's cool here and there if you just really got to do that. But you still got people handling your food and different things like that. It's just something to think about. I know a lot of more people are cooking at home right through here. Y'all just follow these tips and these, change your lifestyle, change your habits. Because, I'm one person. I'm trying to see this thing pass, man. I ain't trying to roll into 2021 and we still dealing with damn coronavirus and all these deaths and everything. So just change your damn habits and take it seriously. Y'all locked down, I'm locked down. So I've been doing a lot of different things. Got a lot of new content on the way. I've been working on a lot of content. All I got is time right now. Ain't no events. Ain't nobody to go out and see. Ain't nobody to go interview. So, I'm just pretty much in the lab, man, creating this content. Also, while you at home, you chilling, different things like that. Obviously, you want some music to rock too. So I'm about to go over my little playlist I put together, and I call it the Coronavirus Lockdown Rap Playlist. It's on Apple Music. I'm going to constantly be adding to it, growing the playlist or whatever. But it's on Apple Music. It's under Drew Soul Quest. So y'all go check it out. But I'm going to go over some of those songs on here, man. Get y'all familiar to some dope music. Because like I said, I am hip-hop. I breathe hip-hop. It's my life. If it ain't dope, I ain't messing with it. Bottom line. I don't care who it is, who you are. Popular, underground, or whatever. If it's dope music, I'm messing with it. Bottom line. DJ Electronica, after 497 years, he finally dropped his project. A lot of people have had a lot of... some people like it. Some people love it. Some people think it's horrible. I mess with DJ Electronica. It's just, I think, for the most part, his project, it didn't live up to the hype. You know what I'm saying? If you got a fan base waiting 10 years for a project, man, when it come out, it needs to be undeniable. I'm sorry. It just does. You know what I mean? You dropped that classic joint, the Exhibit C joint with Just Blaze, one of the best rap songs ever. Just Blaze ain't even on the project. And I don't know, man. It's cool. I think he's incapable of making trash. Another thing, too, a lot of people had issues with the way Jay-Z is on there. Now, Jay-Z is killing it, don't get me wrong, but people just wanted to hear Jay Electronica and not a joint collab project with Jay-Z on there. But there's some joints on there. Probably the best song on there to me, kind of what I've been hearing from a lot of different people, too, is The Blinding. The Blinding, that's the joint featuring Travis Scott. The beat is dope. Jay is flowing. Play this.
This shit make you like talk crazy, crazy,
yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah, that's dope.
Once upon a time there was a little youth, the cub of a lion, stole away captive, a long way home from Zion. The dove prince sang about a purple rain crying to the midget you heard tell of on the shoulders of the giant.
Hey, my son, sir, you gotta call my son, sir. That boy already knighted, he ain't even out his rumper.
He ain't even out his rumper. Obviously, I'm not gonna go over the whole playlist. I'm just gonna go over some of the key joints. But like I said, Apple Music under Drew SoulQuest, y'all get familiar with it. Like I say, it's coronavirus lockdown rap playlist. You know what I'm saying? We all locked down right now. Everybody, including me. So it is what it is. So this joint is Bell. And I don't know if y'all know who Jay Worthy is. Jay Worthy. Now this is a straight West Coast joint. Jay Worthy is on here. Boogie is from the West Coast all day. Who else we got on here? Then we got Jake One on here. So I'm gonna play a little bit of this. This is a straight West Coast joint. Actually, this it's dope as hell, honestly. Check this out. That's nasty. Ugh. Classic West Coast.
Bailin' through my hood on foot though. And that's dangerous. Summertime of war zone. House shoes, ball shorts in my wardrobe. White tees, fitted caps, ain't no thing though. See homies keep the colors in they strays though. Little homies at the park get they bang on. Bitch, you go across the street, it's the same song. No siding with my niggas when they dead wrong. Couple blocks past the lot.
That's actually one of my favorite joints right now, period. That's dope. Let's see what else I'm gonna let y'all hear. The Royce is dope. The Royce is Royce the 5'9". He never disappoints. This is his best project to date. I don't care what nobody say. And it's even more impressive because Royce has never produced anything. He's never produced for anyone. He's never produced any of his own tracks until now. This is the first album. He produced every joint on the album, and every joint on the album is dope. So besides being a legendary elite MC, now he's a dope producer. Like, who gonna stop him? Like, dude is in his 40s, and he's at his prime. He's killing all you dudes right now. He can make tracks and guide with the flow. I don't know. Ain't nobody messing with him. But this one of the joints off of that. If y'all haven't heard that, you gotta hear. Best project of the year so far, bottom line. This is Thou Shall. This is Kid Vicious on here with him. Raw as hell.
Thou shalt not fuck with Detroit me. Never owned a Coogee Ford truck or a pair of them Gator Maurice. Please hold your applause for these parables and stories. Give all praise to Allah, to God be the glory. My papa raised me like I'm a dog with rabies. Playing the hard and the drop Mercedes. Riding with the chopper daily. Pupils dilated like I'm side of baby.
Yeah.
Nozzle on that gun larger than the one on that Gaga lady. Mm-hmm. Play with my time like I'm a playful dime. My arm comes out the car, my window down like I'm trying to borrow some Grey Poupon. First these bitches love it, then they hate it, then they hate to love it.
Then they hate to love it.
I don't care if the radio station's stubborn. Y'all haters busters, I'm David Ruffin. It'll take me nothing to put your life on a dollar menu right
there by the egg McMuffin. Mm-hmm. While these boys order shots, snorting rocks and important thoughts. I'm floating with 40 knots to the bag like I'm a border cop. Any artist in hip hop fuck with nickel stock.
Crazy. Dude is, man, I'm telling you. Let's see. I was gonna play the grab joint. I'll play the grab joint next. So, Ace Hood, you know, obviously, you know, years ago, that's probably been, man, what is this, 2020? Probably, damn, has it been 10 years? No, it ain't been that long. Maybe 5 to 7 years. But obviously, everybody know Ace Hood from Hustle, you know, Hustle. Hustle, Hustle Hard. That was the joint of the year when that came out. Now, at that time, you know, that's when he was heavy affiliated with Ross, heavy affiliated with DJ Khaled. Now, since then, you know, he said they still cool and everything, but business dealings are no more. So since that time, people kind of think he just, you know, ain't doing nothing, fell off. He's had a couple mixtapes here and there in between. You know, but he's still relevant, you know what I mean? He just ain't out there like how he was. Obviously, if you got Ross and Khaled on your team, you know, those are mainstream kings, you know what I mean? You're going to be a little bit more out there. But dude is still, you know, he still got it. He has some quality joints. This is a new one from him called Confident. I really feel this song because, you know, it's dope with the flow and then the content that he's talking about. The name of the song is Confident. He just basically saying, hey, I'm confident. I'm not cocky. You know, I feel that. That's basically how I look at myself. You know what I mean? As a person, as my knowledge with hip hop and different things like that, how I see the industry, how I move through the industry and do my media thing. Hey, I feel a certain way about it and I'm just confident with it. You know what I'm saying? You call it cocky, whatever. I'm confident. So y'all check this out.
Okay. Confident. Never mistake you for cocky. No. Problem is, you only hide what you posse. The boy in here.
If you got a system, this gon' knock.
I wanna pull up to Potsy in a big body.
It ain't no banging system in here, this, but yeah.
I am a passionate daddy. Trippling up on the baggy. They say that boy looking godly. You can feel the energy regardless who you be, you stand in my presence. I speak the truth in my lessons. I keep it true to the essence.
I keep it true to the essence.
Tell you the truth, I'm a legend. I'm in New York with the cushion, the backwood, feeling highly respected. With or without any necklace.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't stand for them pledges.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm equipped with the weapons. Please do approach with discretion. I'm in the gym going eight. I meditate every day. Switch up the way, I'm in the club with my chain. 6% bad on the frame, think it's the game. Fuck all that trying to maintain. We came to buy the whole gang. Positive vibe, humble but ready inside. Them loud people usually less.
Yeah, yeah. Aza still, he still got it. So, I think, play one more. And I'm about to get up out of here and probably be working on some new content all night. But be E first, you know what I mean? Like I said, the stuck in the lab. Hey, I got to make the most of it. Let me see. Actually, I'm going to end it with this. I was going to end it with Graf. Y'all check out Graf as well. Graf is a true MC. Real hip hop dude. He got a dope joint called Blow with Benny the Butcher. Griselda, much love, much respect.
Hey, I'm playing just an ounce of that real quick. Y'all already hear what that song. It's that hip hop.
I was in the bean, trying to get them trees, sent to Juma. Now I'm in the breeze, trying to get them.
Benny is, yeah. Now, I'm going to play this last one. Now, this last one, I guess I'm playing this like I just got familiar with this song today. Well, it just came out like a day or so ago. You know, don't too much get past me. I know everything about everything when it comes to this music and this hip hop culture that I love and breathe and live for. Don't ever get it twisted. I put my knowledge against anybody in the industry. Yeah, that's how I'm in love with it. So K-Camp, you know, K-Camp, Atlanta, got mad flow, dope music through the years, but he got a nice little balance, you know what I'm saying? Even outside of the flow, he can always make a nice little kind of rap slash R&B kind of joint, kind of like I saw Ari the Kid do. Peace, shouts out to him. That dude is dope as well. We saw that years ago, man. We one of our correspondents from Coach 73 interviewed him years ago. We knew that dude was special. But anyway, K-Camp got some dope stuff. So K-Camp dropped a new joint. It got like Ari Lennox on it. Black is on this. Who else is on here? Yeah, Ari Lennox is on it.
Here we go.
Black, I'm missing somebody. Let me see. Oh, and Tink. And yeah, shouts out to Tink, man. Tink is like, don't get me wrong, I'm not gonna probably roll around and bump Tink, but Tink is a super dope, underrated artist. Like, I have not heard a bad song or a bad album from Tink. She is holding it down for the females with the flow and on the R&B tip. But this song is called Black Man Don't Cheat. Now, I know y'all done heard like Lil Duval, Charlamagne Tha God. They be, you know, that's their little saying. They be pushing that agenda. you know what I mean? It is what it is. Hey, everybody cheat at some point in time, but they pushing that agenda, black men don't cheat. So, hey, I'm a roll with that. You know what I mean? But this song is dope. I'm going to let this be the last one I played. I put this on the playlist, even though it's a lot of rap stuff on here. I don't know. It's something about the vibe of this song. It kind of fit into the songs. You know, y'all let me know if it don't, but I'm going to play it anyway. Because like I said, you on lockdown, I'm on lockdown. That's part of being on lockdown, too. Like I said, it's going to be a lot of physical things going on with the opposite sex. So, yeah, to fit this into your playlist, too, let this roll. It's a dope song. See, this the song where if you are cheating on your girl, but you trying to make her think that you're not, or if you trying to transition out of a situation so you officially not cheating on her, yeah, come up behind her, play this song, and just come up behind her and hold her a little bit, groove with her a little bit. If you know the words to it, sing the words to it. This is a nice little groove. It might help you out of a situation.
She said I got another one. She said I seen it come. She said I seen it come. She think I'm messing around. She think I'm cheating on. She think I'm messing around. She think I'm cheating on. She said she feel different. She said something missing. Think I'm buying a trick. But you know that ain't a kiss. I love playing with you. I love kissing on your body. I love praying with you. Baby, put that in my face. All alone with nobody.
Put it in my face.
Started shit on purpose. Don't worry, I'm steady curving. Bitches make her nervous. You tripping, I think you perfect. All that fuss and fighting is hurting. I'm out here working. Think I'm cheating on her. She think I'm cheating on her.
think I'm cheating on her. They think I'm cheating on her. They think I'm messing her. They think I'm cheating on her.
She think I'm cheating on her.
They think I'm cheating on her. She says another one. She said I got another one. She said I seen it coming.
Yeah, this playlist, I'm gonna be adding to it probably daily at this point. Y'all probably be seeing me daily too. Right now it's like around 20 songs on this joint. The coronavirus lockdown rap playlist. It's on Apple Music under Drew Soul Quest. So y'all get familiar with that. And like I said, man, stay healthy, stay blessed. Hey, I hope, like I said, all my little tips and tricks that I showed you that I'm on right now to stay healthy and keep my immune system up through this hard and trying time. I hope y'all learn something and just keep it going, man. Like I said, let's change our habits so we can move forward and change the world and get rid of this corona, man. It's real talk, but it is what it is. Drew Soul Quest, you've been watching Quest Convo, the coronavirus edition, and we out. Culture 73 Studios, chilling on the lockdown, on the quarantine, creating that content for the people. And that's it. We out.